President Trump is speaking in the Oval Office. We need to go to it.
The economy is booming. We're the envy of the world. Other economies are not doing well, and we're doing record business. So we're very happy about that. And it's really great to have the Prime Minister of Ireland with us. Well, I think he's got a lot of hand movement. I've never seen so much hand movement. I said, is he crazy or is that just the way he acts? So I've never seen hand movement. I watched him a little while this morning doing, I assume it was some kind of a news conference. And I've actually never seen anything quite like it. Study it. I'm sure you'll agree.
Joe Biden.
I just say whoever it is, I'll take him on. Okay, him or her. Whoever it is, I'll take him or her on. And I think with the economy doing so well, with all of the things we've done, with the tax cuts, the biggest in the history of our country, tax cuts, with people having a lot more money in their pocket, with their 401ks hitting record numbers, they've never been considered great investors by their wives or by their husbands, whatever it may be, and now they're considered great investments. But the market's hitting almost new highs, and I have all of the records, every single record I have, every single record for the stock market. So I think it's going to be very tough to beat. If you look at African-American, if you look at Hispanic or Asian unemployment, we have the best records in history. In the history of unemployment, we have the best records. So I think it's going to be tough for somebody, but you know what? Whoever it is, it makes no difference to me whatsoever. I'll be coming at some point during the year. I missed it last time, and I would have loved to have been there, and it's a special place, and I have a very warm spot for Dunebeg. I will tell you that, and it's just a great place, really great.
Mr. President, yesterday you made a decision about the Boeing planes. How long do you think that they will be grounded?
Oh, I hope it's going to be for a short period of time, and I hope it's, look, they have to find out what it is. The biggest thing is they have to find out what it is. I'm not sure that they know, but I thought we had to do it. We had to take a cautionary route. The grounding of the planes yesterday was a big thing, as you know, and you're involved with Boeing also.
We've done the same, yeah.
The grounding was a big thing, and it's a great company. It's a truly great company, and hopefully they'll figure it out very quickly.
Mr. President,
it's a big decision. It's also one of our largest exporters, one of our, truly one of the truly great companies of the world. They have to figure it out fast. They know that. They're under great pressure.
Why did you make that decision so much later than other countries?
Are you still a great supporter of Brexit, given how things are?
Well, I was. It wasn't that I was a supporter. I predicted it was going to happen, and I was right. And people laughed when I predicted it, and they won by about 2 points. And I was standing out on Turnberry. And we had a press conference, and people were screaming. That was the day before, if you remember. I think you were there. And people were screaming. And I said, no, I think it's going to happen. And people were surprised I made the prediction, and because President Obama made the opposite prediction. And I was right. And I will tell you, I'm surprised at how badly it's all gone from the standpoint of a negotiation. But I gave the Prime Minister my ideas on how to negotiate it, and I think you would have been successful. She didn't listen to that, and that's fine. I mean, she's got to do what she's got to do, but I think it could have been negotiated in a different manner, frankly. I hate to see everything being ripped apart right now. I don't think another vote would be possible because it would be very unfair to the people that won, that say, what do you mean you're going to take another vote? So that'll be tough. But I thought it would happen. It did happen, and both sides are very, very they're cemented in. It's a tough situation. It's a shame. Frankly, it's a shame. There was no reason for that to happen. They could have had the vote, and it should have gone smoothly. Unfortunately, it didn't. Very complicated issue. And actually, the issue on the border of Ireland is one of the most complex points.
Do you think it should be extended to get more time?
Well, I think they're going to probably have to do something, because right now they're in the midst of a very short period of time, the end of the month, and they're not going to be able to do that. So it's going to be. But I'd like to see that whole situation with Brexit work out. I'd like to see. So, we're talking to them about trade, and we can do a very big trade deal with the UK. We're also renegotiating our trade deal with the European groups and, literally individual nations, and also with the whole. But It's very sad to see what's happening there. And there was no reason, and I'm sure, Leo, I'm sure you agree with that. Do you have any feeling on, would you like to express your feelings on Brexit?
Yeah, well.
Maybe I should not let you do it. I'll just get you in trouble.
We have a different opinion, President. I regret that Brexit's happening, and the UK was a really important part of the European Union, but they're going now, and that's their decision. But the most important thing for us in Ireland is that their decision to leave shouldn't cause any problems in Northern Ireland, where people actually voted to stay, and that we shouldn't have a hard border or anything to disrupt the peace process. And also we want to make sure that we still have frictionless trade between Britain and Ireland, because I believe in free trade, and I think it'll be a few years until the United Kingdom sorts itself out. But in the meantime, the European Union is available to talk trade with the US.
And we're talking about trade with the European Union. They've been very, very tough over the years. They were unwilling to negotiate with the Obama administration, and they were unwilling before that, to be honest. I'm not just blaming President Obama. But they're willing to talk to us, and if they don't talk to us, we're going to do something that's going to be pretty severe economically. We're going to tariff a lot of their products coming in, because the European Union treats us very, very unfairly. I have to say that. Very, very. They treat the United States, and they have been for many years, for decades, they've treated us very unfairly. So it'll probably work out. They're negotiating. They want to see if they can get. Otherwise, we're going to do something that's going to be good for the United States.